Hello everyone, welcome to this video. We're going to learn topic 5, electromagnetic induction. In this topic, we have 5 subtopics, and that are magnetic flux, induced EMF, self-inductance, energy stored in inductor, and mutual inductance. So first, let's begin with 5.1, magnetic flux. So what is magnetic flux? Magnetic flux is the number of magnetic field lines that is passing through a given area. So basically, the more the number of magnetic field lines and the bigger the area, that will give you greater magnetic flux. To calculate magnetic flux, is the scalar product between magnetic flux density, and that's the symbol B, with the vector of surface area, and that's the symbol A. Or if you write it down, phi, which is the magnetic flux, is equals to B dot A. Or phi is equals to BA cos theta, where theta is the angle between B and the vector A. Do take note that the direction of vector A is always perpendicular to the surface area. So magnetic flux is a scalar quantity, which means it has no direction, and the SI unit is Weber or Tesla meter squared. Okay, so let's say there are 3 different orientations between the magnetic field and the plane of coil. The first orientation, if the plane of coil is perpendicular to the magnetic field, and the second one, if the plane of coil is 30 degrees to the magnetic field, and the third orientation, if the plane of coil is parallel to the magnetic field. So let's say the surface area is 5 meters squared and magnetic field is 6 Tesla. So for the first orientation, the vector A is exactly the same direction as the vector B. So that means the angle is 0. So that gives you the magnetic flux phi is equals to B times A, or 6 times 5. And that gives you 30 Weber. And for the second orientation, the vector A is 60 degrees to the vector B, so that gives you 6 times 5 times cos 60, and that is 15 Weber, and that means the flux is positive. And for the third orientation, the vector A is exactly 90 degrees to the magnetic field, so cos 90 degrees is 0, and that means the magnetic flux is 0. So therefore, we can make the conclusion that the magnetic flux is maximum if the plane of the coil is perpendicular to the magnetic field, and it is minimum or it is 0 if the plane of the coil is parallel to the magnetic field. Now let's look at magnetic flux linkage, or it's the total magnetic flux with n number of coils. So magnetic flux linkage, the symbol is uppercase phi, is a measure of the total magnetic flux that passing through a coil with n number of turns. Or if you write it in equation, magnetic flux linkage, the capital phi is equals to n is the number of turns of the coil multiplied with phi, the magnetic flux passing through one coil. Now let's try a sample question. A coil with 500 turns is a coil with a radius of 2 cm. It is placed in a field of 0.6 Tesla such that there is an angle of 30 degrees between the field and the normal to the cross-sectional area. Calculate the magnetic flux and the magnetic flux linkage. Alright, so it's given that magnetic field is 0.6 Tesla, and area you can calculate with pi r squared, so pi times 2 centimeters
squared gives you 1.26 times 10 power negative 3 meters squared. And the angle between vector B and vector A is 30 degrees. So you put that into BA cos theta. So 0.6 times 1.26 times 10 negative 3 times cos 30 is 6.55 times 10 power negative 4 Weber. And the magnetic flux linkage, you just multiply it with 500, and that gives you 0.33 Weber as the magnetic flux linkage.